Namaskar, hello everyone. Welcome to the 11th episode of season 3 of Money and Prosperity. I'm Ashok Vyas, program director with ITV Gold and founder president of Insight for Creativity. Today, we'll continue our discussion with Paresh ji about factors that prevent people from being financially secure for retirement. Paresh Shah, as you know, is the CEO of Paresh Shah Financial Services. He is a certified financial planner and wealth strategist. He has served for last 21 plus years and helps individuals and businesses co-create innovative financial strategies. Paresh ji is a licensed CPE presenter. He has educated CPAs as they guide their clients on investments, life, disability and long-term care insurance. He specializes in pension plan, profit sharing plans, asset protection, estate planning and business succession planning. So much Paresh ji is in a position to do, as he graduated as a chemical engineer, honors graduate from prestigious Indian Institute of Technology at Kharagpur, India. He's a 2016 honoree for Long Island Business News Leaders in Diversity Awards. There has been a transition in his life. He resides in the town of Hicksville in Long Island, New York with his wife Shimul and their son Shamik. And as I welcome Paresh ji, I would also ask this question again to you. First of all, let me have the pleasure of welcoming you.
Namaste, Ashok ji. Thank you so much for the warm
So, Paresh ji, one, I want to convey to you that I meet a lot of our viewers who are appreciating Money and Prosperity, and some of them wonder, chemical engineer and then financial professional, what is the connection? And I said, we did talk about it, but there's no harm in you briefly mentioning about it again.
Sure. I mean, there was a phase in my life when I graduated in 1991 as a chemical engineer, and then I worked as a chemical engineer for 5 years. But there was I had joined my family business of pharma manufacturing, and unfortunately at that time I lost my dad, and it was a joint family business, and things didn't pan out the way I had expected them. So I was looking for a change. Financial planning gave me that one opportunity to kind of use my engineering skills and yet at the same time creative.
Absolutely. I was just interrupting you to bring it towards the poetic side. So there is a chemistry between you and financial planning, I poetically would like to say, and let's jump into today's theme, which again is very important.
Maybe there is an engineering to it.
There is engineering to it, absolutely, absolutely. And that inner engineering is now a trademark of Sadhguru. But there is this structure of understanding of life, which is partly also a trademark of Paresh ji. As we were talking about longevity and how retirement planning is related to longevity, and now traditional retirement planning sometimes doesn't help the way people want that it should help them, and we have discussed many challenges, and somehow when you face that which is challenging, then you become brave and actually you are more prepared. So briefly, I'll mention, you talked about the potential threat that retirement planning has from inflation, then interest rate risk is there, and then market risk of course is there. So now you gave us so many challenging scenarios. Is there something more to it that you want to add, or there is more that we should look at?
Ashok ji, I think probably one of the biggest factors today which affects seniors, or with anybody, you know, is what would happen if our health was not proper, or what would happen if the health would fail. And that mindset or that risk or that challenge becomes a little more ingrained in the mind of the senior, because as you grow older, you feel that the chances and the probabilities of those kind of issues coming up and those kind of challenges coming up are more and more and more. So that, I think, is always there, that healthcare seems to be at the front line of thought process of any person who is retiring, about to become a senior. Having said that, when we talked about, you know, in the earlier episode, we mentioned that longevity tends to compound all other issues or make them more serious or more severe. And healthcare is one such thing that has done that. I mean, because healthcare costs, so to say. Why is that? Because as you live longer, like let's take the simple example of cardiac diseases. So less than 10 or 15 years ago, the moment a person had a heart attack or a cardiac disease or something like that, it used to be that, my God, you had to slow down in life, you couldn't do so many things, and it was a serious challenge. Today, this, yes, it is a serious condition, but there is so much treatment and so many things happening that even after a cardiac incident happens, people have a very, very long life. But what do they have along with that long life? They have to have medications, they have to have procedures, they have to have so much health checkups. All those things come in. And that means the per person cost across the retirement ages of healthcare is going up. Now, in our country, fortunately, we have the Medicare system. What is the Medicare system? That is a person who turns 65 and has worked for more than 40 quarters is eligible to get Medicare at the age of 65, which is state-run health insurance. And again, like Social Security, where we talked last time a little bit about Social Security, the Medicare program was meant to be there for maybe 10 years, but now Medicare treats a person from 65 all the way to 95. And as age goes up, the procedures become more and more complex and more expensive. So why are we bringing up Medicare just now? Over and over, various governments and various presidencies and Congress have talked about that the percentage of expense that they're making on Medicare is so high, such a high portion of the budget, that they have to cut back. Now, what will happen when they cut back, when the government cut backs? The cost on the individual will go up. So retirement.
Yeah. I think I asked you the right question, and you are scaring us a little bit more. But along with the potential understanding of the threat concern, then we also try to figure out in what way to prepare. So let us restrict a little bit about learning related to medical program.
Yes. So Shukji, the Medicare is a very, very complex program. And there are lots of subparts to it. Of course, as I said, you're applicable to get the Medicare program if you have worked for 40 quarters and you're over the age of 65. And it's a health insurance. Now, there are two ways you can get Medicare. First of all is what we call Part A and Part B. Part A and Part B means Part A is for hospitalization, and Part B is for the visits to the doctors and all other care. And then there is Part D, which is meant for our prescriptions that you need to take. So there are three parts to Medicare: Medicare Part A, Part B, Part C. Each of these in turn has a series of deductibles. That means that the amount of money that you have to pay out of pocket before Medicare starts kicking inside. And you know, it is hard to remember all these numbers, so I'm going to refer to some numbers.
Absolutely.
On my sheet here. You know, like for Part A, for the first 60 days of hospitalization, the deductible is $1,316. That means you pay $1,316 out of your pocket, and the remainder is paid by Medicare. From 61 to 90, the copay is $329 per day. So it goes up. And then between 90 to 150 days, the copay is $658 per day. And beyond 150 days, all the costs are borne by the patient.
Oh man.
So the hospitalization itself can be a major expense if it goes beyond a certain number of days. Now, you may have heard of cases where there are some very severe accidents and people have got 2, 3, 4 months of treatment. As you can see, you go well beyond the 150 days, but when you come out of that, the cost is so high. Now, the second part that we have is Medicare Part B. So Medicare Part B is for doctor's visits, and that has a deductible of $183. And after the patient is the patient is responsible for a 20% co-insurance. So this is about Medicare. Now, you know, all these numbers really, in the end, they don't make sense. But what they need, what we mean to say here, Ashokji, very clearly from all these numbers, you can see that there is nothing, it is not completely free. You will have to shell out some money out of your own pocket. Money to pay the premium, which is essentially taken from a person's social security income. And second is money is for the copay. And that income must come from your retirement account. There is one program outside of this, which is known as the Medicare Advantage program, which kind of combines A, B, and D. But you know, sometimes there are big challenges. Like one couple realized they took Medicare Advantage to save money, and they realized that when they traveled overseas, they were not protected against health insurance. So each of these things has an advantage and a disadvantage. You need to look at very carefully what you need to do. I know I gave a very long answer, but Ashokji, I need to explain one more thing before we go to any next question.
Yes, sir.
There's something known as Medigap policies. So you remember this whole list of copays and co-insurances that I read out to you? If you get a Medigap policy, then they can pay that. But again, you have to pay the premium for that. So
this is a pretty, it sounds very complex overall for someone who is just thinking about one figure which you mentioned, that if you are there for n number of days, this much is per day, and over 60 or 90 days, something like that, you are saying that $329 or $89 per day, all these figures, and you start thinking in your mind, where am I going to get that kind of money at that position? And there could be some people who are facing this scenario right now. So now, these are the additional costs which are very difficult for anybody to take care of, even if they have made a lot of money. I mean, you don't end up making infinite amount of money. So now, if you have some idea as to the estimate on that cost, which will that help in some way navigating through?
Yeah, I think there, you know, it's never possible to make a perfect estimate, but I would say that the cost of the premium, right, plus the cost of all this copays and everything, can be approximately, you know, about $12,000 per year. So $12,000 per year is a substantial amount of money. Let me just point out once again, I said cost of the insurance. That means those who take Social Security income, a portion of that Social Security income is used to pay Medicare premium. So that plus all the copays, averagely you need to take into account about $12,000 a year is going to be paid by you.
Man, and how do we plan for that?
I think the planning should begin a lot earlier, because you use the word planning. That means you need to a lot in advance think about what you need to do. We start with doing what's called a basic questionnaire. And in the questionnaire, or we take some questions and we do an assessment, which tells us how much money will be required by a particular person, depending on various factors like income and the taxes and that they'll pay and whether they'll get a pension or not. We take all those factors into account. And then what we do is we can plan out that you can put aside a pool of money from which you can get regular income to pay off all these expenses. So that, I think, would be one of the methods that we would definitely use. But as with all the things that I say, Ashokji, the most important thing is to be cognizant, to not just walk in blind, to be cognizant that this is needed and to start doing it from a very early time.
So the time to do, start doing something in this direction is now. Because now is the best time when you should be aware that what you are likely to need. And I speak in this manner, resonating with the spirit which brings Paresh Shah Ji, financial professional, to ITV studio to share all this wealth of information and indeed to get in-depth, direct help or guidance from him. The number to reach is 516-268-3446. With lots of good wishes for you, sir. Thank you very much for joining us here at ITV studio. With thanks to all of you, this is Ashok Vyas.